what happens is quite often you're not getting these spiritual experiences anymore. These moments that you just go into meditation and you go into divine oneness is not happening. So, and it's a confusing period. You can't go back now. You can't go back to ignorance. You can't go back to being asleep again because the spirit has shaken you and awakened you. And some of us will try. We'll try to go back. We'll go back to the booze or drugs or whatever habits we have and kind of numb ourselves so maybe I can just fall asleep again. But that doesn't happen. No matter how hard you're trying to numb yourself with all kinds of different substances or destructive relationships, sexuality, danger, food, you can't go back. And it seems like you can't go forward either. So you fall in this abyss of confusion. And you start going around and round and round. You're going around yourself. In this period, it may happen a few times in your life. It makes you, forces you to dig deeper and bring you out of this comfort zone, and you go out there, starts looking for spiritual teachers, going to different seminars, workshops, reading different books, listening to different people on YouTube, hoping to find a way to make you feel good again, to create those blissful states that you were in, and to get back into that. And maybe sometimes you get a glimpse of it. Another carrot is dangling in front of you. But in a lot of cases, you can't recreate that. So now the spirit wants to and is forcing you to dig deeper inside. So a part of that, you may just enter into a cult or follow what people call a fake guru or a controlling narcissist kind of a guru who is very strict and is going to torture you in some way or the other. And so a lot of people fall into that. And they put a number of years into a relationship with a spiritual teacher, which is sort of abusive. And you get out of that too, eventually, and you wake up out of it. When you finish your karma, whatever that is that you have to finish. I'm not saying that happens for everybody. I'm saying it's generally the pattern for most spiritual seekers. So this pull-push with the divine self is going to continue, is pulling you in, giving you some spiritual experiences, and then kind of leaving you. It appears to be that way. That you're cooking inside yourself, you're cooking within, and it's a very confusing period. And a lot of times you may feel like, okay, I don't want to live anymore, I want to kill myself, you know, I've gone through that. And there's a lot of suffering in this period that happens to a lot of spiritual seekers. And then they do a lot of guru hopping, searching, trying this, trying that. It's very confusing, especially nowadays because of the internet and so much information is available. And also this industry has, this path has turned into business too. It was always some sort of it, but now it's more of a business as in comparison to 50 years ago. So because there's a lot of demand for it and there's a lot of money in it. So but then you may come to another period that you give up the spirituality and you go to the world. And I went to that period too. And you say, you know what, hell with this. I don't give a damn about God or self-realization. And I want to go out there and make money. Or I want to go and have a family. I want to have a child. I want to settle down or whatever. Whatever is that your priority at the moment and you, your desires. So in my case was I want to go out in the world and make money and retire early so I can just go and play around. So I turned my back to the path. But now I know that I never really turned my back to the path. It appeared to be that way. And that may, you just may go on for 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. And then there's one way, one day you look back and you say, oh my God, I lost my path. What happened to me? I used to be very spiritual. I used to practice. I used to meditate. I used to do yoga. Blah, blah, blah. And now I haven't done anything. And then you slowly get back into it. Something happens, pulls you back in. So if you're in that place or you've experienced it or you go through it, know that that's normal too. That is a part of the whole process. Even though you feel like you stray away and you got lost, that was meant to be. It's a part of you being cooked. It's a part of your being in this pot of stew, and the master is cooking you, is preparing you. The master chef is getting you ready. It's possible on this path that you have a heart-to-heart connection with an external teacher, with a guru. And whether the guru is real or fake or whatever, it doesn't matter. And you have a really heart-to-heart connection and you get really dedicated on that path with your guru. And everything is groovy for you. And then it may something happen that that connection breaks, or you get sick of the guru or the teacher or teachings, or a lot of times the guru does something you don't like, because a lot of us are projecting that the guru should be a saint and they can't do anything wrong. And it, depending on the group, what the group, what values they hold highest. So if their values is that their spiritual teacher is vegetarian, is not having sex, she's not having sex, she's celibate, whatever is the totality of the group, and they hold these values at the highest point, they're projecting it on their teacher. And some teachers, they play that game.